being very, very careful and not getting caught up in this is what I think I'm supposed to do because what everybody's telling me I'm supposed to do, right? And years ago, when I first started my consulting business, it was back in 2000, I think one of my first clients was a gal that was an attorney. And she had just started her own practice and she'd come out of a big, you know, one of the big giant law firms here in Phoenix. She loved working in the firm. And I was talking to her about, why did you do this? And what's your vision? And what do you want to get out of this? And after we talked for a little while, she says, you know, I really love being in the big firm. You know, I enjoyed it. I love the people. I love the camaraderie. I love the banter. I said, well, why did you start the business that you're in now? And she said, because everybody said it was kind of the next progression.
Very
interesting. And I have to tell you, it was the shortest consulting engagement that I'd ever had.
We had your job.
I talked her out. After our second conversation, I said, what are you going to do? And she says, I'm going back to the law firm.
That's awesome.
Because it connected with authentically what she didn't want to create that. She wanted to be a part of it. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I say to people, really get in touch with it. And you said the same thing. Get in touch with why are you doing what you're doing? And it can evolve, but be authentic to where you are today. And if you feel compelled that, hey, I'm being challenged to do this because I want to explore this next level of leadership, but understand that in order to go there, you're going to have to let go of something.